Today, I'm going to show you how to take your iPhone photos and videos and transfer them over to a Windows machine using a USB cable. What is going on, everybody? Hope all is well and welcome to another tech tip style video. Today, we're going to be showing you how to take your videos and your photos from your iPhone or your iPad and transfer them over to a Windows machine using a USB cable. Now, of course, this method is a little bit older as far as a transfer method, but it works really well if you don't have the ability to wirelessly transfer those files over to a different machine or if you currently don't have service for any type of cloud services. Now, before we begin, you're going to need three things in order to do this process. First and foremost, you're going to need your iPhone, your iPad, or your iOS device that has the videos and files on it. Second thing is, you're going to need a Windows machine in order to transfer them to that machine. And of course, in order to do that transfer, you're going to need a USB cable, one that supports data transfer. Some third-party cables will only support the ability to charge, and typically using the one that came with the device is going to be your best bet. Once you have all three of those things mentioned, you are ready to go. The first step is to, of course, take your USB cable, take one end of it and plug it into the computer, and then take the other end and plug it into the phone. So in this case, I'm gonna take this end and plug it into my computer's USB. And then I'm gonna go ahead and take the lightning end and plug it into the phone. And you're gonna get an audible tone from the computer letting you know that something has been connected. Now, on the phone, you're going to need to unlock it in order to complete a full connection. So if you have a security code, you're gonna need to type that in. If you've got facial recognition, whatever it is that you have set up to unlock your iPhone or your iPad, go ahead and do that in order to complete. Once you've done that, you're going to get the message just like this. It might be a little hard to see, but it says, trust this computer. Your settings and data will be accessible from this computer when connected wirelessly or using a cable. You can either click trust or don't trust. In order for us to transfer the files, you will need to go ahead and click on trust. Once you've done that, it is going to ask for your PIN code or your passcode in order to confirm the computer trust. Type that on in. Once you've done that, the passcode's gonna go away, but it's going to make a complete connection to the computer, and we're ready to find the files to begin the transfer process. If for any reason your device is not recognized by the computer, there's a few different troubleshooting steps that you can take. First, try a different USB port, because allowing you to swap to a different USB port may prompt the computer to reinstall the drivers of the phone or the device and actually get a better connection that way. The second thing is if you have a secondary or another cable that you can try plugging that in and trying different various ports as well to see if you can get the computer to recognize your device. If your device still isn't recognized by the computer, there's a good chance that you can go in and reinstall the drivers of the device in order for the computer to see it. To do this, go on down to your start menu in the bottom left or wherever you have your start menu located, right click on it, and then left click on Device Manager. This is going to bring up a new window that's essentially got all of the different devices connected or drivers installed on your machine. You're going to want to look for something that says portable devices and then click on the arrow to the left, kind of drop down the drill down, and then you can see right here, I've got the Apple iPhone in there. Yours might say Apple iPhone as well, or it may say Apple iPod or Apple iPad. Whatever it is, what you're going to do is right click on it and then left click on update driver. This little window is going to pop up where it's going to say, how do you want to search for those drivers? And you're going to choose on search automatically for an updated driver software. And you're going to want to, of course, make sure that you are connected to the internet, because it's going to go through and check for a new driver. If it doesn't say anything and it does say this where it says the best drivers for your device are already installed, go ahead and click on close. Go back to the Apple iPhone, and then you're going to want to go ahead and click uninstall the device and then click uninstall one more time. From here, you can either unplug the iPhone or plug it back in, or you can come up here to this little icon right here where it's got like a computer monitor with a magnifying glass and left click on it to scan for hardware changes. As you can see in the bottom right-hand corner, it has now detected my Apple iPhone and it's already reinstalled the driver of that particular iPhone.
By now, if you're still not seeing any type of connection information, there's a chance that the phone may have timed out in this process. Just look on the phone and verify that it is still unlocked.
So two things are gonna happen when you first get the device to be recognized by the computer. First, iTunes may come up, and if it does, feel free to go ahead and close it. The second thing is, pops up in the bottom right-hand corner, as you can see, where it says Apple iPhone, select to choose what happens with this device. From here, I'm just gonna actually go ahead and click on this dismiss button,
because I'm going to be opening up my own File Explorer window. We're going to be creating a new file to send the photos to, etc. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on the X. From here, go ahead and find the File Explorer icon. And if you don't see one, again, right click on your start menu and then left click on File Explorer. And this is going to open up a File Explorer window like you see here. From here, if you notice, you may be under the quick access on the left hand side. What you're going to want to do is actually come on down and select on this PC. From here, under the devices and drives, you'll notice that the Apple iPhone is listed right there. Yours may say that. Yours may say Apple iPod or Apple iPad, just like when we were troubleshooting the device drivers. In any case, what you're going to want to do is left click or double left click on Apple iPhone. Because Apple products don't typically have a slot for a micro SD card, you're going to only have one option in here, and you can see that it says internal storage. We're going to go ahead and double left click in here again. And on this particular phone, I only have one folder that says DCIM. This stands for digital camera image, and this is typically where your videos and your pictures are going to be stored that were taken from the camera on the device. So again, we're going to go ahead and double left click in there. And here's where things might be different for your guys' devices, just depending on how many folders or how many pictures and videos you have. You may have one folder that says 100 Apple. Yours might be named slightly different. You might have multiple files. So this is the part where you're going to have to go through each one of those and determine the files that you're looking for and what folder that they're in order to transfer them over to your Windows PC. So in this case, in today's demonstration, it's super simple. I don't typically use this as it was an old phone and it's just kind of sitting around. I only have one folder, but I'm going to go ahead and double left click on this 100 Apple folder in order to get to my files. Once you've done that, you can see that there's some files in here for today's demonstration. But before we do anything here, what I'm gonna want to do is find out and figure out where I want to store these photos that are gonna be transferring from the iPhone over to the computer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually gonna open up a new window because this will allow me to drag and drop the files that I want to in the folder that I want. So if you look over here on the left-hand side, I've got something called a My Book. This is an external hard drive that I'm going to be transferring these photos and these videos too. So what I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna right click and then left click on open in new window. This is then gonna open up a drive, another Windows Explorer window, but it's going to be in the drives or the My Book directory, as you can see right here with all of the different types of folders. Now, Windows has something really cool, and if you're unfamiliar with it, it's called Windows Snapping, and this allows you to move your windows around and works really well for such as today's demonstration. So what you're going to do is if you just click and hold on this window, and I'm just gonna drag it over to the right-hand side, you'll notice that it gives me a gray outline of what's gonna happen to this window. Once you've got that outline, release the left hand, or the left click, and you'll notice on the left, it's gonna say, okay, we found these other windows that are open. What would you like to do with it? Well, since there's only one right now, we're going to left click on it and it's going to fill up the left half of this monitor in an even manner in order for us to be able to move the files back and forth, which is really convenient. So we're just gonna go ahead and left click on it. Now you'll notice that each window just takes up a perfect half of the monitor and will allow us to kind of work between the two really easily. Now, there's a few different methods that we can use in order to transfer these files over into this drive. First, I'm gonna come over on the right-hand side and I'm going to make a new folder either by clicking on, right-clicking on, going down to new, and then left-clicking on folder, or a keyboard shortcut is Control-Shift-N as in Nancy, and that will allow me to create a new folder, and we're just gonna do demo test for today's demonstration. From here, this is where I'm going to transfer the files on my iPhone over to My Book external hard drive. So now that I've got this here, I can either leave the demo test in this directory or I can double left click into it. And of course, since it's a brand new file, it's going to be empty. What I'm going to do is there's three different methods that you can use to move these files over, as I was mentioning. First off, you can left click and hold, and then you can drag and copy. You can see where it says copy to demo test. You can drag over here and then release the left key, and that will transfer them over to the new folder. You can also highlight them like this. You can right click and you can click on copy, and then you can right click on the folder and then left click on paste, and that will move them over as well. There's also a few keyboard shortcuts that you can use. If you left click on one, hit Control, and select another one, this allows you to individually select or deselect an image in order to transfer over. So say we wanted to do picture number one, and we'll do picture number two and three. You'll notice that these two are JPEGs, which is a picture format, and you'll notice that this one is a movie format, which is a video. We're gonna go ahead and click on those, and you can drag them over once you have the appropriate one selected. The next thing that you can do is if you click on one and hold shift down and then left click on another one, it's going to select the first one and the last one, but also everything in between. The third option that you can do is you can hit control and the letter A as an alpha, and that stands for selecting all. And you'll notice once I typed that, or once I clicked on that, it's going to select all of the files that are currently in this folder. So as you can see, there's a few different methods that you can use to transfer these files back and forth. And depending on how you want them to transfer or which ones to transfer, you can use the keyboard shortcuts to make that happen. So for today's demonstration, we're just going to use the Control A method, which allows us to copy all of the contents of this folder. And then we're going to go ahead and right click and click copy, and then let right click in the folder on the external drive, and then left click on paste. You can see a little transfer bubble is going to pop up here and then quickly disappear, mainly because these files aren't terribly big, so it was a relatively quick process. Another method that you can use just to kind of see in action is, again, we'll do the Control A, but then we're also going to do Control and the letter C on the keyboard, and this tells the computer to copy everything that is selected. We're then going to move over to the external drive folder and hit Control V as in Victor, and this is going to tell the computer to paste the copied file contents that you just copied. So if we hit Control V, you'll see once again the transfer bubble is going to pop up real quick, but you'll see that the files have been moved over. Another thing that you can do to make the transfer process a little bit easier to manage is if you come up to View on either one of these windows and then select extra large icons, you'll notice the thumbnails of those images or those videos are going to be extra large to allow you to see what that photo is and see if that is one that you do want to select. And again, we'll go over to the external drive, click on View at the top here, and then click on extra large icons, and you can see that they are exactly the same because we've made a direct copy of those files and put them on the backup folder that we have on the external drive. So just a kind of a quick thing here, again, it's Control C, Control V. I'll actually be leaving the keyboard shortcuts in the description below. So if you have a hard time understanding or you need a quick refresher on which ones are which, I will go ahead and list those out in the video description so you can guys can kind of use that as reference.
And that brings a wrap to today's video, bringing us into our question of the day. And we're gonna be a little bit creative with this one. I wanna know what the largest or the biggest file transfer process that you've performed. Leave your answers in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and found it useful, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it on all of the social media platforms. Check out some of the other videos that we have on this channel. We are tech focused. Here are a few examples for you. Subscribe if you're not already and enable the bell notifications so you guys don't miss out on any type of future content. And we will see you on the next one.